Hey there everybody, how's it going? Trem here. Well, as you can probably hear on the video, it's the stock exhaust back on the Honda. And well, there's a really, really sad reason for that. As the title may sort of give away, the Honda is literally leaving now. I'm driving it to the new owner's house. So, yeah, the road that I came, this is the exact same road that I came down when I first rode it for the first time. At the end of the video, I'll be putting some snippets in of some of the great adventures that I've had on this bike, so please stick around for that if you've enjoyed watching me ride the RVF over the past 2 years. That's how long it's been. Nigh on 2 years of this bike now. About like a month or so, but... So this entire vlog is going to be a complete memorial to the RVF. What a bike it has been to me. Yeah, I've had my ups and downs with it, but it has been a superb bike. All in all, the only time this thing's ever let me down is with that clutch cable snapping, and that is totally unforeseen. But seriously, what a bike. I'll be so, so sad to see it go. And if I didn't need the money for a new bike, I wouldn't be selling it. I bought this bike 6,000 miles ago. I've put 6K on the clock, which ain't too bad actually for 2 years of owning. And I've tried to sell it twice already, believe it or not. But this time was the time that I put the most effort into selling it. The other two times I put it up for one ridiculous offer, another ridiculous offer, and this time I priced it fairly reasonable. And some guys have come and offered me money for it, and I'd be stupid not to take it. So yeah, Honda has sold. It's going into a great hands though, which is nice to know. Like, I reckon someday I will see this bike on the road again, because they're going to fully restore it. They're going to like make it like a minter from the garage, like it's just come out the showroom. They own a VFR 400 as well, so it's going into like a little collection, which is really nice. And it's just nice. And you guys might think I'm being ridiculous. Some of you guys might not understand, you know, why I'm being so dramatic, some would say, about this bike being sold. But having a bike for 2 years, you kind of make a bond with it, you know what I mean? There's so many memories of me riding this bike. I've been to Scotland on it. You know, I had this bike when I first met my girlfriend, and it was my first big bike. I've been to the Lake District on it. I've done 6,000 miles here, there and everywhere on it. And I don't know, it's the first bike I did a proper wheelie on. There's loads of little memories that I've got entangled up with this bike. And it's going to be really sad to see it go. Oh, I'm going to miss that as well. Oh boy, I'm going to miss that. The 400 pull. Granted, this bike has finally broken me. Hence the reason I decided to sell it in the first place. My neck is an absolute state at the minute. I think I'm actually going to have to go see a chiropractor or something, because my neck is just not right. I'm losing sleep over it and shit. It's awful. I don't know. It's because my legs are so high on the Honda and I'm leant over so much that my neck's like crammed into my back. And I think I might have, I don't know, trapped a nerve in my neck or something. And it's not the first time it's happened. I've had to go to the chiropractors like 5 times before because of this. So that will be one thing that I'm not sad to miss, but I wouldn't sell it if I didn't have to. If I had the funds to just buy the bike that I wanted next and to keep this, I would just keep it under a sheet, just because it's such an awesome bike and they're so freaking rare. You know, I don't think I'll ever find another one of these, unless I've got like, I don't know, by the time I'd want another one of these, they'll probably be about £12,000-£14,000, if not more, because that's the type of sport classic this thing is. What the fuck is going on here? Okay, the traffic is horrific today. Let's be very careful, because technically this isn't my bike anymore. The guy has already paid for it, so this isn't my bike anymore. Which is actually really weird to say, that I'm not riding my own bike. I don't know why the traffic is so freaking bad today. No idea what's going on here. My favourite memory of the RVF was going to Scotland on it. If I hadn't gone to Scotland on it, I'd have been kicking myself right now. But because I did 900 miles in 3 days on a 400 Supersport and I had the time of my life on it, you know, oh, it was such an amazing time. And I couldn't have chosen a better bike to do it on at the time. If I'd have bought anything else whilst still being on the license I am, you know, it wouldn't have been as fun as the RVF. Just such a light bike. Bags of power. You know, it was really, really awesome to do. And a little bit of history behind the Honda before she finally leaves. I bought it in Manchester off Speedwell Motorcycles in Manchester, or Rochdale even. And yeah, now a lot of you guys, if you haven't already got the gist of why she's going, I want the money in place to buy my first big bike. You know, for when I pass my test, I want to be able to just pass my test, go out and buy the bike, you know, that I want. Instead of like being like, right, I've passed my test, now I have to sell the Honda. I won't have to worry about that. One thing I'll super miss about this bike, which anyone who's owned a bike for a long time and ends up selling it will totally understand here, is the effortless riding. Because I've ridden it for so long, I don't have to think when I ride this bike anymore. It's just kind of like, it's all natural to me. And that's just going to be so sad. I'm really going to miss it. It'll be horrible on weekends now, where it's like a really nice day on a weekend and I could be going out on the bike, but I don't have a motorbike. You know, that's going to kill me. God, the stock exhaust does sound shit. How did I have this exhaust for like a year? Unbelievable. Well, the last coming weeks of owning this bike have been great as well. I've done the Squire's Egg Run, and I went to Lincoln Sports Bike Shop for another time. So, you know, all these vlogs I've recently uploaded, they've been great memories for the Honda. Really nice send-off. It really has been a great bike to fucking have, honestly. I wasn't actually gonna buy this bike when I was looking at A2 bikes. For some reason, I wasn't convinced that an SV650 would satisfy me enough. I was kind of wrong about that. And I was originally looking at a CBR 400. I was looking at one in Preston, and I nearly ended up buying it, but my dad talked me into getting this instead. And I'm really glad that he did. Oh my god. I think this is the first time I've ever shown you guys, like, Clifton traffic at peak time. But yeah, this is Clifton traffic. It's fucking shit. It just reminds me so much of London. Cars being unforgiving. Everybody trying to kill me on a bike that's not even mine. I'm just gonna have to take it steady. Say goodbye to her, last V4, Rev, and well, I'll see you guys when I get my new bike. Take it easy, guys.
Today I am going to be doing a bit of review on the new bike. I haven't really ridden this thing very much. I mean, I went out on it last night because I was dying to have a go, like dying to have a go. This thing's got so much power, you wouldn't believe it.
Oh, fucking hell.
Oh, shit.
It's good.
We both did the same thing.
Just coming to visit this house. Fucking hell. Well, riding that without a clutch, majority of it. I did about 7 miles, 10 miles without clutch. Just knocking through the gears. I know it wasn't good for my gearbox, but I didn't really have a lot of options there. Something good and something new.
now.